Hi friends, and welcome to Crumbs from Gerard. Today I would like to speak to you on the importance of family life. We cannot manage without family. In fact, that's what we see so clearly in the Bible. The Bible begins with family, Adam and Eve, and ends in the book of Revelation with the marriage of the Lamb. Right in the beginning, when God created, He created family. Adam and Eve. And we realize how important family is. In fact, the New Testament also starts with the family of Nazareth. When we look at the Ten Commandments, we see the way the Ten Commandments have been numbered also gives us a clue of the importance of family. There is a Jewish tradition that when God gave the commandments to Moses, they were, as we know, on two tablets. On one side, there were three commandments, the first three, and the other side, the remaining. The first three deal with God. The first commandment we know clearly, I am the Lord your God and you shall have no other. In other words, the first commandment sets the tone for all the other commandments. It tells us the priority will always be God. And once we put Him first in our life, then everything else follows naturally. On the other side, the other tablet, we had seven commandments. And what is the first commandment over there? The fourth commandment. And what is it? Honor your father and mother. Now, this is not by chance. God placed among our relationship with other people, first of all, our relationship with family. When we put family first in our relationships, everything else falls into place. So putting God first, you have all the other things in place. And when you put family first, then you have everything else in place in our relationship with people. So when, in other words, our relationship in our family is good, our relationship with society moves on smoothly and beautifully well. Now, sometimes we tend to think, you know, today families are under tremendous amount of stress. These days, we find it so difficult to live in family. It's not like in the past when there was no stress. No. Stress has always been part of family life. Take a look at the very first family. Adam and Eve. Adam blames Eve. Eve blames someone else. They become refugees, they are thrown out of the Garden of Eden, the most beautiful place, thrown out. Change of work, occupation, as we know, now they were tillers of the land. And worse still, in the very first family, murder. Cain kills his younger brother Abel. So, stress. So stress is part of family life. At no time in history, family has had no stress. In fact, what we know of stress is nothing compared to the stress we realize families are going through, war-torn areas, refugees and such kind of stresses. And yet we know family is of vital importance. And we see this not only from human beings. We see this also the importance of relationships even among the animals. I remember when I was a young boy, outside my school, I watched a cow giving birth to a calf. And when I saw the little calf being born, immediately when the calf fell to the ground, it stood up and immediately went to drink milk and was managing on its own. And I said, strange. We take so many years as human beings, but here this little calf could already stand up. It took a little time to straighten out, but then at once seemed to, okay, in a little while it will manage on its own, but not with family. But closer to us, I once watched on TV, this was a very beautiful scene of these monkeys. I don't remember what kind of monkey, but they were all sitting in a group and there was a little baby monkey just born. And what they did was so beautiful. The first one took that monkey. I don't know which was the mother and which was the father, who was the rest. But the first one took it and gave it a hug. And then passed it to the next. And the next one gave it a hug. and next, and it went on like that. In other words, monkeys, supposed to be closest to us, they need love. And that's what we know much, much more as human beings. We are created for love, and to grow, we need love. And what we are in our youngest years and what we experience carries on in life. The first 6 years of a child, we know, are crucial. And in those crucial years, the child is learning. And who is the closest to a child in the first 6 years? The family. Mommy, daddy, brothers, sisters. You are what make your family, in other words. You are absolutely important for your family. I would now like to read to you from something from the Compendium of the Social Teachings of the Church, number 212, and it tells us something about the importance of family. The family is of central importance in reference to the person. It is in this cradle of life and love that people are born and grow. It is in the family that the mutual giving of self on the path of man and woman united in marriage creates an environment of life in which children develop their potentials, become aware of their dignity, and prepare to face their unique and individual destiny. This is the importance of family. This is what it means to have family and what a family does for a child. My dear friends, I suggest that you put on your thinking caps and think of your own family right now. And if you can kind of create, what is that image that comes to mind when you think of your family? To give you an example, your most comfortable chair. In other words, for you, your family is the place you love to be in. Or you might get the image of rope all knotted up. In other words, your family needs to sort out some differences. What is the image that comes to your mind as you think of your family? But no matter what you think of your family, you need your family and your family needs you.
Lord, open my heart during this minute meditation.